Do you all think all these people are resting in peace? Do you all think all these people can terrorize their own people and then go to the afterlife and rest in peace? Is that what you all think? You all think they can rap about death, destruction, and damnation, get paid for it, live a lavish lifestyle, and then rest in peace afterwards? It's not how it works. You see, we turned our back on God. That's not how it works. There's no way you could think you could live that kind of life on earth and then have peace in the afterlife. There's no way. If that was the case, God wouldn't be God. The universe wouldn't be the universe. And God created the universe. If that's the case, reaping and sowing wouldn't exist. If that's the case, karma wouldn't exist. That goes against everything existence is about. Where you can cause all kind of mayhem and chaos and destruction and death and then rest in peace afterwards. Who are we fooling? It's a setup. Do you understand? It's a setup. They are setting us up. There's a reason why you can't talk about the ills that are really plaguing our community.
Be willing to give up what you were to become what God wants you to be. And your problem is you keep wanting to hold on to the old nigger you. You don't want to give up the world. You don't want to give up your nigger way in order to become God. That's your problem. So you're half stepping when you should be running.
Let me say this, and I hope many of you all are offended. You can't rap about death, destruction, and damnation and expect the universe not to answer. You can't rap about death, destruction, and damnation and expect the universe not to oblige you. If the power of life and death rests in the tongue, what makes you think you can make money off of spreading death, destruction, and damnation and not be held accountable? Do you understand these are spells and chants of death on our people? Do you understand that we kill each other more than any race or ethnic group in the world? Do you understand that? And nobody wants to talk about that. Nobody wants to address that. Do you understand we worship a culture that is detrimental to us? We worship a culture that is detrimental to us. We are literally preaching, promoting, and being entertained by death among our people.
On the dial when I broke it down with my team, boy, I am so goaded. I always stuck out in the crowd when I was a child. Was special and my mama noticed. That nigga cool, but find you the coldest. I live my life like a book and I wrote it. I drop a song and these niggas quote. If he looking for me, I'm probably where his hoe is. Only for bitches, this bad ain't got no kids. I'm going crazy like I ain't got no sense. You and that car and that bitch ain't got no tips. We pulling up and we letting up for niggas. Don't need cap credit, we giving out facelifts. He breathing hard, don't think he gon' make it. I shut the block up and they have my face mask, so I'ma stay in. That's how my day ends.
This thing is spiritual. So what makes any rapper think they can promote death to their people and nothing's going to happen? You're going to be held accountable for that. Do you understand that we kill each other more than anybody else in the world? Do you understand that? And these white liberals and these Democrats and these liberal black people and these black Democrats tell you that you cannot talk about the homicide rate in our community.
And you wonder why you're not successful. You wonder why you're not as fortunate as you want to be and could be. Just look at the nigger that's hanging around your neck. And get rid of it.
Brief side note. And so there's two reasons why these things are going on in our community. The first reason is a lack of God. And the second reason is a lack of family. Because what happens is when the family structure is destroyed, a nation is left vulnerable. You see, when the family structure is intact, it builds a strong community and then it builds a strong nation. So if we combine a lack of God with the lack of family, then there's no way we can succeed. When the family structure is not intact, meaning the father is absent from the house, all chaos will ensue. If you look at all the statistics that negatively affect a person, look at their family background. You see, the family structure is God on earth. That's the man, woman, and child. That is the husband, that is the wife, that is the child or the children. That is what keeps a nation intact. That is what keeps a community strong. It's the family structure. Without the family structure, chaos will ensue. So it is very intentful to make someone like me seem like a sellout if I dare address the homicide rates in our community. And many of you all think I'm a sellout because I care enough about my people to tell the truth about what's actually going on.
Every time they see me, I'm on go. Freezer in my lungs. I say that every time because he got smoke. Fuck how you feel for real. My best friend, he got killed. We was in that field for real. Blowing niggas down, boy, come here. Everything I say, I mean it. 690 say he seen it. They know King Von the Demon. We call that boy anemic.
Nigga don't stand in my face, they say when I turn my back, little nigga, let's do it. Ain't got a back though, ain't gotta snake you out, little nigga, you know we into it. Nigga, you ain't good in your hood, you can't even go to your hood. Why you trying to blame your hood? You don't wear chains in the hood, you don't even claim your hood. Yeah.
And we don't think we're gonna to have a heavy price to pay. Do you all understand that what comes out of your mouth has a benefit for your life or a consequence for your life? This is not personal. This is not about being black. It is not about being white. It's nothing to do with race or color or ethnicity. This is how the universe works. You reap what you sow. What you all don't understand is we are sowing death. So we are reaping death. We are sowing poverty. So we are reaping poverty. Everything we're reaping, we are sowing. But they're telling you that it's racism. It's not racism because we have the power. The problem is we turned our back to God. And because of that, we are suffering. Because of that, they're predicting zero wealth in the black community. Everything they did to us was a ritual, from hanging us to castrating us to sodomizing us, raping us, to chopping us up, ripping our bodies apart, burning us at the stake, tarring us. All these things were rituals. All these things were done to reinforce a self-perpetuating curse that would last for centuries. You all keep bringing up Willie Lynch. This is beyond Willie Lynch. They were casting spells on us, and now they get us to cast spells on ourselves.
Where's the out of here?
Home invasion.
Home invasion.
Robberies.
Robberies.
Homicide.
Homicide.
First degree.
Damn.
If you ain't caught you none, you better catch you some.
Better catch you some.
If you ain't got no gun, you better get you one.
Better get you one.
I make shit shake.
Shake.
Up in broad day.
Yeah, yeah.
No face ain't no case.
No case.
Learned that the hard way.
Damn.
I'm posted in Parkway.
Uh-huh.
Fuck what the narcs
say. They
say. Just hit a quick stay now. What? I'm running through gangways.
How does a rapper that's a role model, that's a figure in our community that young people look up to and many adults, how can a rapper atone for spreading death, glorifying death, preaching death to our community? How can a rapper atone for spreading death, destruction, and damnation and making a profit off of it? Do you understand these artists get paid to sell us death? These artists get paid to cast spells of death on us. How do they atone for this? Our family structure has been intentionally fractured. It's been intentionally attacked. They don't want our families intact because if our families are intact, they can't push these agendas. Imagine me not being able to address the homicide rate in our community. Imagine how sick it is, how psychologically sick it is for them to tell you, and you all believe that I am a sellout and against my own people because I dare talk about the homicide rate in our community. That, at this point, quite frankly, is an epidemic. And if you hate the truth, then you hate God. And that's at the core of the issue. We hate God because we hate the truth. There's no way we can expect to rap about death, destruction, and damnation of our people for years, for decades, and expect to get away with it.
Y'all know I love music. I love a lot of rappers, got a lot of love for them. So I'm not speaking on all, I'm not generalizing all of them. But I will tell you, your enlightenment is not the true goal. Listen, if they had a book to tell you how to get money, they probably wouldn't show it to you. They'd rather get on Instagram and show you this and count their riches in front of you with their babies and tell you how they don't fuck with broke niggas and they don't fuck with broke bitches. Listen, I'm gonna say it one more time if you missed it. If the goal was your true enlightenment, you probably would have stopped following them a while ago because you were already superseded their expectations and their success level. That is the real nigga versus the reform nigga theory.
If you broke, go to work. Make that big booty. Work. Make that big booty. Work. Can I touch that booty?
It is impossible to be righteous and emotional. These rappers will keep dying, and we will keep dying until we have some character. But if I get down to the core of the issue is we don't care enough about each other to want things to change. We just care about who's president. We just care about who's in office and who we'll be able to laugh about or cry about. I care about my people, no matter who doesn't.
Mogul and they know that. Logo on my flow mat. Courtside Chamberlain throwback match my Rolex. Everywhere I go flex, valet park on some low shit. Whole lot of smoke in that Rari, that thing poke. Burning rubber, wearing cameras that was undercovers. Under pressure, made statements turned on their brothers. Never judge you, but the streets will never love you. I wonder what it comes to in your brain for you to run to. Ones to hate us, handcuff us and maces. Call us dumb niggas cause our culture is contagious. Third generation South Central gangbangers that live long enough to see it change. Think it's time we make arrangements. Finally wiggle out that maze.
Wait for it, Free Blast, get money.